Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing great. Today I'm going to share the third tutorial in my LabView series, and in this tutorial I'm gonna explain all about functions palette. In my first video we have seen the basic introduction of LabView software, and then in the second tutorial I have shown you how to deal with LabView environment, while in this third tutorial I'm gonna show you how to use functions palette. Now, in order to open functions palette, what you need to do is you need to right click in your block diagram section. So now once I right click here, then you can see a new window opens up which is named as functions. So that's our functions palette. It has named functions at the top, and then we have a search box here on the right top corner. So if you want to search any function, then you can use this search box. So let me give you an overview of what this function palette is. First of all, if you are working in LabView, then what you need to understand is, if you are working on any third party hardware or software, then you need to install different packages in LabView. These packages are actually libraries in LabView. Means like I have once worked on Skype. And in order to interface that Skype device with my LabView software, I have to install its Skype package, which you can see here, this Skype driver. You can call it package, you can also call it LabView driver, and the third name could be LabView library. So when you install any of the LabView package or LabView driver, then its functions are appeared in this functions palette. So we have different functions here. First of all, we have this programming section at the top. In this programming section, we have structures, and then we have arrays, clusters, numeric, boolean, string, and many more functions. And similarly, we have measurement input output. If you are working on some device, then and you want to measure some parameters, then you can use this measurement IO function. And after that we have instrument IO, and that's not necessary that you have all these functions in your functions palette, because if you haven't installed any of these drivers, then these functions will not appear in your LabView software. So first of all, we have the structure section here, and if we have a look at the components of structures function, then we can see we have for loop, while loop, then we have time structure, case structure, event structure. These are all the loops which can be executed in LabView environment. So for example, if I want to use while loop, then what I need to do is I just need to click on this component, and then I have to drag it in my block diagram area, and you can see we have our while loop. So in LabView you don't need to write any code. You just need to select components from the functions palette, and then you need to drag and drop them in your block diagram area. I'm going to explain all of these features in my coming tutorials in quite detail. So now moving on to next function, which is numeric, next library. In numeric library or numeric driver, we have different numerical operations. Like if we want to add two integers, then we can use this add function. We can use subtract, multiply, divide, and then we have few complex functions here like arithmetic sum. After the numeric library, we have boolean. In boolean, we have all these boolean gates. Like if you want to add two boolean values, then you can use this AND gate. Or if you want to OR, then you can use OR. And if you want to combine different gates in one component, then you can use this compound arithmetic function. So I will also cover these functions in my coming tutorials. Next we have timing function in our functions palette. And in timing we can see we have different counts. Like if you want to create a stopwatch, then you can use tick count function. And if you want to wait for, you want to add a delay in your simulation, then you can use this wait millisecond function. So we have many elapsed time function, and here's another time delay function. We can use all these timing functions available in timing palette. Okay, and if you want to work on graph, then we have this graph area. And if you want to work on file IOs, then we can use this separate function in which we can write or read from different text files or XML files. So that was a brief introduction about the functions palette, in which we have seen that what is functions palette and how we can use different functions available in functions palette. If you want to add any third party functions, then you have to download its package, and using LabView package manager you can install those packages and get their functions right in your functions palette. So in my coming tutorial I'm gonna explain briefly So in my coming tutorial I'm gonna give you an introduction of controls palette, and we will see how to use this control palette in our front panel. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye bye.